United States, has topped the Billboard singles chart twice, and has released a debut album which went triple platinum. Before we meet her for a chat, here's a quick look at the song she'll be performing for us later on. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Taylor Swift.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you guys?
Welcome.
Nice to meet you.
Let's
go straight into your opinion as a role model for young girls about the topic we were just discussing. What advice would you have given to that mum who said she can't get her daughter to stop obsessing about the way she looks, how much she weighs? You must have been surrounded by that kind of stuff.
It's such a tough age, 14, because that's when you feel like the only girls with boyfriends are the pretty girls, and the only girls with the most friends are the skinny girls. And you don't realize that, you know, if you have something about yourself that makes you different, you should embrace that. I think when you get into the real world, even when you get into high school, you start to realize that. I used to hate my hair. All the popular girls had straight hair, and so I used to spend hours every morning trying to straighten it. And, you know, I put myself through just all the pain and the time and getting up 2 hours early before school just because I wanted to look like everyone else.
Yeah.
And at that time in my life, I didn't realize that if I had something that was different, that I should like it.
Yeah.
So what age did you discover that it was all right to have curly hair?
I was 16. Yeah, so this was through a year of high school, and I just looked around and I realized, you know what? It's okay not to wear the same clothes that everyone else wears, and it's okay to not have the same hair that everyone else has. But, you know, if you think about human nature, our favorite pair of shoes is the one we bought yesterday.
Right.
Our favorite thing is the newest thing that we have, and if you think about the thing that we've seen the most and for the longest period of time, is our reflection in the mirror. So obviously that's going to be our least favorite thing.
What about your success? When did you first realize that you had such a gift? Because you write, you play, you sing?
I don't know. I think that, you know, I've always loved music and it's always been a love for music. I never actually thought that this would actually work out for me. So this is just a nice surprise.
Yeah. It's massive though, isn't it? I mean, you're so sensible for someone who is so successful already at such a young age.
Thank you so much.
Your parents must be brilliant.
My mom's amazing and my dad is amazing, and they're total opposites. My dad is a super fan who sells t-shirts at the merch booth and hands out guitar picks to fans.
Does it worry you though? Does it worry you that you might go off the rails? That, you know, with all the success that you've had, or you're going to get more, obviously. Does it worry you a little bit?
No, not really, because my mom could care less how many records I've sold. My parents are complete opposites. My dad's like, hi, nice to meet you. I'm Taylor Swift's dad. Nice to meet you. like the proudest dad you could have. And then my mom is the one who, before an award show, she'll be like, look, honey, you're not going to win this one.
you're so down to earth. Do you think that one of your reasons for success is that young girls relate to you? They can see you. They can see you've not changed. You're quite ordinary, really, in the terms of what we look at pop stars now. Do you think that's part of the success?
Well, I just think it's really fun to have a bunch of new friends now, you know? All the girls that come to my shows and the girls that are waiting outside the radio stations and all those people that I've gotten to meet, it's like I consider those people my friends, and this has all just been like a dream come true. I am an ordinary person. I just have a different schedule now.
Just having an extraordinary, extraordinary life. We've got a new single coming out, Love Story, which you're going to perform for us at the end of the show. And your new album, Fearless, as well, is out. Is that March 19th, I think it is, in this country?
Yeah, I think it comes out March 9th.
But you're off to the Brit Awards tonight. Is that just fun, or is that work for you?
It's just fun. This is the first award show in a very long time that I'm just going to watch. And I'm so excited.
who do you most want to meet?
Well, I've met my top two that I wanted to meet. I wanted to meet Duffy and Adele, and I met them at the Grammys. And they were really, really nice, so I was excited.
Well, you have to tell us what's best, the Brits or the Grammys. You'll have to come back and tell us.
I think they'll just be different. I'm just predicting they're going to be different.
Very different. Well, listen, thank you so much for joining us. Congratulations on all your success, and we can't wait to see you perform later.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Music sensation, Taylor Swift.
Yeah.